Hi, my name is Kevin Backhouse. I'm a security researcher at Semmle. This video is about an integer overflow bug that can cause error conditions to get accidentally ignored. I'm going to show you how to write a query that finds variants of that bug. The query that is from a blog post which I wrote recently about Libssh2. You can see it here if you scroll down in the blog post. This is not the query that found the CVE, which the blog post is mainly about. While we were looking at the source code for Libssh2, we noticed another bug which had been introduced on their development branch. And the good news is that this query was able to find all the variants of it before they released a new version of Libssh2. So let me just quickly show you what the bug is. So here you've got a call to this function libssh2getcstring, and you can see that it sometimes returns a negative number as an error code. If we just go back here, now you can see that the type of plen, which it's assigned to, is an unsigned long. So that means that if the function returns an error code, then it will trigger an integer overflow here, and this less than zero condition will never fail. So the error code will get ignored. That's probably not a good thing. So let me show you how we can write a query to find that kind of bug. So first of all, just going to write a very simple query to find return statements that return a negative number. Most of these, of course, are not going to be bugs, but we're going to make the query more sophisticated. So there's an example where we're returning -1 as an error code, probably. So what we're going to do now is we're going to connect that to the call where that function is called from. So what I've done here is I've added a function f and a call, and I've said that the target of the call is f and the return statement is in the function that we're calling. And so if you run that, you can see that we've now matched up return statements with where it's called from. So here we've got a return of -1 in a function called netconf readUntil, and that's where it's called from there. And this one you can see is being handled correctly because there's a good check there and there's no problem. So what we're going to do now is we're going to look for cases where that call is cast to an unsigned type. So what I've done here is I've added this extra line of code here, and what it's saying is that the fully converted type of a call. So in C, often you have both explicit casts and implicit casts. An awful lot of the time, the C compiler is inserting implicit casts for you. And what get fully converted does is it gets you the end of the chain of casts, so you know what type it's going to get converted to. So we're asking for the fully converted expression, and then we're getting the type, and then get underlying type strips off things like type def, so we find out what the type really is rather than the type def. And then we say that we're only interested if that type is unsigned. So if we run that query, then we can see now we've just got 22 results. So these are good results that we're finding here. So you see this in this example, we've got a call to that function that we saw before, getcstring, and it's getting assigned to rlen, which is an unsigned int. So that is an example of the bug. Now, the query that I wrote for the blog post is just slightly more sophisticated than what I just showed you here. So in the next iteration of the query, what I'm gonna do is I'm also gonna handle cases like this example. So in the previous version of the query, I was only looking for cases where the result of the function is immediately converted to an unsigned. But what sometimes will happen is that you'll assign it to a signed integer, and then sometime later on, that gets converted to an unsigned int. So what I've done now is I've imported our dataflow library, and I've said that there's a source and a sink, and I've said that the source is the function call, and the sink is the thing that gets converted to unsigned. So let's see what happens when we run that query. Now, what we see here is that some of these results are not very good. So this one is kind of weird. We've got a call here and it's saying that the assignment expression is async. So the mistake that I've made in my query is that I have got data flow from the function to anywhere where the type of the sync is unsigned. And that's not really what I want. What I actually want is I want to find the place where the transition happens from signed to unsigned. And right now, I'm not restricting it to just those places in the query. So in the final iteration of the query, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add one more condition. So what I've done here now is I've imported the range analysis library, and I've added one extra condition, which is that the lower bound of the sync must be negative. So what I'm saying here is that the sync itself should be potentially a negative value, but it gets converted to something that is unsigned. And the reason why I'm using range analysis to do this less than zero check, rather than just saying the type of sync.as expression is signed, is that it allows you to handle slightly more sophisticated cases like this example that I've got here, where you've got an if statement that does a bounds check on the value of R. Range analysis will know that at this point where you use R, that it is definitely a positive number. And so the query won't give you a false positive result for this example here. So it just makes the quality of the query slightly higher. And if we run this query now, we can see that we just have 13 results, and these are all good results. These are all true positive results that we get here. So one final thing to mention is if you are working on a software project where you use negative numbers as error codes, then I really recommend that you give this query a try. You can see here in the blog post that there's a link to the LGTM query console, and that shows you the results on Libssh2. If your project that you're working on is open source, then you can grab this query and try it out on your own project and see if you've made this mistake in your project. Thanks.